Hello students, this is the class 6 video, chapter 7, getting to know about the plants. So, we see a variety of the plants in our around us. We can classify the plants according to their shape, size and having the colors. So, we can also the classify the plants according to the flowering and non-flowering. The plants that flowers, they are known as the flowering plants. That are not bearing the flowers is known as the non-flowering plants. For example, rose, hibiscus, marigold, etc. These are the flowering plants because they have flowers. So now next, non-flowering plants. For example, fern, mosses, etc. These are not having the flowers because due to the presence of her and due to the different habitats present around us. Next is that we can classify the plants on the basis of their size and nature. On the basis of the plants, we can classify as herbs. If plants has a green, tender stems and it is salt, and we call it herb. And are therefore used to making the medicine or as a spice, etc., is known as the herbs. Herbs has a small size and smooth and soft structure of the plant stems and branches, etc. They do not have any branches. They do not have many branches, such as the banana is a herbs, mint is a herbs, ginger is a herbs. So next is the shrubs. Plants having a hard but thin stems are called shrubs. They are taller than the herbs, smaller than the trees. They generally branches but from a vases. Lemons, hibiscus, or cotton are the all types of the shrubs. So next is the tree. Plants which are taller and having thick woody stems are called trees. They are taller and having the hard shape and hard structure of the stems. So the main stems is very thick and contain the branches, such as the mango tree, peepal tree, neem tree, etc. These plants having the heavy or strong branches and stems, but also having the thick modified stems. So now next is that creeper. What do you mean of the creeper? Creeper is the plants, they are not upright but spread on the grounds. They have a thin big stems, such plants called a creeper. For example, watermelon, pumpkin, gourd, etc. These are the example of the creeper. Now next is that climber. Climbers are the plants. They are still some of the plants which have been weak stems and need to support. The climbers also known as the supporting plants. They climb on the trees or walls. For example, grapevine, money plants, etc. These are the climber plants because whenever you have to seen these plants, they are the creeper. Creep on the wall. They are the climbs on the wall stems, etc. And another plants. So this is also known as the climber plants. Now next is the plant system. Now here you have when you see in the picture, the down part of the plant is known as root system, and upper part of the plant is which are upon the soil. Above the soil part is known as shoot part, but shoot part have stems, bud, leaf, flowers, fruit, etc. And down part, which is dumped into the soils, is having the primary roots, secondary root, and tertiary roots. So now next is the root system. What do you mean a root system? The root system consists of root and its branches. It is generally found under the soil. This is the root and having the branches is roots. And kinds of the roots. Roots are two types. First is tap root, second is branches tubes. whenever you have to seen that a heavy thick thin fleshy fleshy muscles taps of the roots is grown into the plants, this is known as the tap roots, while other as the fibrous types of branches known as the fibrous roots. The plants in a plants having a having tap roots, one long main roots goes deep down into the soil, is called a tap root. It contains branches which spread sideways and are called a lateral roots. For example, radish, beetroot, mango, tea, gram, etc., having the tap roots. Next is the fiber root. These are the thin and almost of equal size. They are started from the base and of the same stems and spread in the soils. These are busy in the nature. For example, grass, maize, rice, onion, etc. So, you have to also you have seen in our around us find out how many plants having the tap roots and how many have the fibrous roots. Find out the other example by your practically way. Now next is the what is the function about to the roots. Root what is the what is the work about to the plant roots in a plant's body. So roots help to hold the plant firmly in the ground and prevent it from the carrier away by the behind of flow away flown away by the water. They have to store, they have to hold to the plants from the flown away from the ground, and they also absorb water and nutrients from the soils and making the for making the food. Roots binds soil particles together and prevents the soil erosion. It is also help to the help to prevent from the soil erosion because the roots are hold the soil particles and not which are not flown away the winds or water. The next is that modification of roots. Roots in some plants, roots are modified into to perform some other functions, such as the roots of the plants are modified to store the food, such as the radish, carrot, sweet potato, beetroot, etc. These roots having the fruits and have stored the food product in them. And next, roots of the some plants such as the sugar cane, bamboo, and banyan are modified to give the extra support. Plants, these roots grow downward from the branches, reach to the ground, and thus give the support stems of to the plants. And these are called the prop roots. For example, bamboo. Whenever you have to see in the bamboo, this is the bamboo plants, and this is the sugar cane, and this is the banyan tree. When the plants is so old plant, then when the tree is so old, then it grow advanced roots which help to support to the plant's body to hold the weight of the branches. So next is that some plants have modified the parasitic roots that help to absorb the water and minerals from the host plant body. For example, tota plants. Next is that roots of some plants, such as the dahlia, modified that can develop into the new plants. These can be modified into the new form and the new baby plants by itself. Next is that arrange the following in increased order of their height. According to the heights, you can arrange the plants or trees, herbs, shrubs. You can do according yourself, and if you have any doubts, then you consult with me. And this is your task to complete it. It is in your book. The next is shoot part. Shoot part is the above part of the plant body. Shoot system mainly contain the stems, branches, leaves, flowers, roots, etc. That grow above the grounds. Stem is the main part of the plants. Stems, function of the stem. What is the function of the stems? Stems keeps the plants erect and the bear the leaves, flowers, fruits, etc. It is the main organ of the support. It conducts water, minerals from the fruits and to the other part of the body. It conducts the food of the food that leaves is leaves to storage organs and to grow to the growing the part of the plants. Green stems can absorb the food from the for the plant body part. In the some plants, stems are modified to the perform the special functions like the storage of the food, production methods, etc. These are the special types of the function which is performed by the stems. So now, modification of the stems. Some stems, stems of some plants such as the grapevine and passion flowers are modified as stems, tendrils to give the support to the plants. Some stems have converted their body into forming a tendrils. Tendrils are the branch of the tree which help to supporting the plant body part. Why it capture the other body part, other part of a another substance and to stand their structure. Now next, that some of the plants are modified to store the water and prepare food. For example, cactus desert plants store the water in the stems and soil up. The stems of these plants become leaf thick and perform the photosynthesis. Now next is the stems of the some plants such as a potato, ginger, onions, eggs are only onions are modified to store the food. It is for example potato, ginger, onion, etc. These plants having the stems. This is the stems also, which is dumped into the soil. It having the food to using now for using by the animal or organism. Potato are called the tubers, gingers are known as the rhizomes, and onions are known as the bulbs. Okay. Next is that these are the kinds of the stems which is converted after the modification. Next. Stem of some plants such as the rose, jasmine are modified to grow into the new plants through their stems cutting. Some if you observe the ends of the stems into activity, you will see that the end of the look as shown in figure. End of the stems. Red have a red types of the jasmine have a rhizome. They are the tissue inside the stems which act as the pipes and conduct the water to the leaves. These are the pipes or vessels which help to sheep the water, food, and minerals, etc. from the soils and the plants, leaves to the all other part of the body. So these are the leaves. What next is the leaf? Leaf is called a food factory of the plants. It is a thin, flat and broad outgrowth of the stems. It is attached to the stems of the plant at the point or called the nodes. When the plant's body is attached a leaf, this is known as the nodes. The older leaves are generally placed lower at the stems as stems grow apart. When a plant's body part is grown up, then older leaves are downward and new plant's leaves are grown upward sides. Now next is the parts of the leaves. Leaves are the following types. First is petiole. Petiole is the branches which have the a small stalk by which leaves is attached by the stems is called a petiole. Some plants like the wheat, rice, maize do not have the petioles. Some of have not petioles because their body their leaves are attached via directly joined with the stems. Next is the lamina. Lamina is the broadened expanded part of the leaves. It is called a lamina of a blade leaf blades. It is green in color due to the presence of the chlorophylls. And the green color of the leaves due to the presence of the chlorophyll, which is helped to forming the food by the help of the photosynthesis process. Now next is the midribs and veins. Midribs and veins. The veins like structure, the stalk of the leaves, which is the part of the stems contained in the leaves, into the leaves or lamina, forming the center veins are called midribs. And the midrib branch into veins, which form network in the leaves. The arrangement of the veins is called a venation. The network of veins, veins is known as the venation. Venation are two types. Reticulatory venation or parallel venation. When the veins are forming a network across the leaves of the both side is known as the reticulatory venation. For example, peepal, china rose, mustard, etc.
veins runs parallel to reach the we call it is parallel plantation. For example, banana, maize, bamboo, sugar cane, etc. Now, function of the leaves. Function, what is the function? We have to know about that. Leaf is the food factory. So, the main function of the leaf is to prepare the food. Leaves generally have a green color, presence of the chlorophylls. The process of the producing food by the leaves. By a leaves in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll using the water and carbon dioxide is called a photosynthesis. This is the definition of what is the photosynthesis. A process in which green plants make their own food in the presence of sunlight, chlorophyll, CO by using the CO2 and water is known as a photosynthesis. This is the equation of what is the photosynthesis. Oxygen is given out in this process and the food presence is prepared in the form of the starch. When the food is prepared in this process, it forming the starch. We can test the presence of the starch in the leaf by carrying out the following activity. When you want to check out the activity, starch in the solution, you can do the following activity. For example, when dip the leaves into the alcohol and boil it for some times, then then added the some iodine solution, their color becomes blue black. It show the presence of the starch. When the iodine colors convert into the blue and black color, this is showing that the presence of the starch. Next is transportation. Do you have the sweet on the hot summer day? We sweat because it keeps our body cool. Similarly, plants also lose the water through their leaves. This is called the transpiration. Whenever you have to see the water droplets above the leaves blade, and during the winter time, summer times. This is known as the transpiration. Losing the water particles from their leaves is known as the transpiration. If you tie a when you want to check out this activity, you can do the activity for as shown in the figure. You tie the polythene above the leaves. So after the next morning, you can find the some droplets around in the polybags, which show the transpiration process. Transpiration cool the leaves. It is called it is also creates a pulse in the leaves due to the presence due to pitch, water and minerals are moved up to the stems from the roots. Therefore, the transpiration help in the transportation of the nutrients in the side of plants. Transpiration also in maintaining the water cycle in the nature. Now next is the respiration. Respiration, exchange of the gases in the plants takes place in the leaves. The leaves contain the small pores through which they take in the oxygen and give out the carbon dioxide gas. However, the amount of the oxygen taken in by the plants is much less than oxygen given out during the photosynthesis. During the respiration, the amount of oxygen is so lesser, while the amount of oxygen produced in large quantity during the photosynthesis. Modification of the leaves. Leaves of some plants are modified to give in the support of the plants for giving the tendrils. Generally, climbers have the tendrils that help the climbs the green pea. Leaves of some plants, such as the cactus, are modified into the spine to reduce the loss of water from the plants, as well as the protection from the beings eaten by the animals. Animal leaves of some plants store the food as are eaten as a vegetables. For example, spinach, cabbage, etc. These are forming the leaves as a vegetables. Leaves of the pitcher plants is modified to forming a pitcher to capturing the insect. It is the various function about the
plants. It is also the function of the plants and also modification of the leaves. Now next is that flowers. Flowers have the falling parts such as the sepal, petals, pistil, and stamens. Now let us discuss about the flower part. It is very easy to identify the plants from its flowers. Flowers is the most attractive part of the flowering plants. Why which any other organisms are attracted towards its flowers? Maybe have many sizes, but most of them are brightly colored. They are the organ of the reproductive part of the plants. So now the part of the flowers. So first is the sepals. Sepals, these are the small green leaves like structure present at the base. This is the sepals, which is present at the base of the flowers. They protect the petals in the bud stage and provide the support of the petals when bud opens to form. This is the petals, and they help to support and help in the support for the petals. For instance, now petals, these are the flat, blurred, generally colored structure present in the flowers. They are maybe in one or more layers. They may be separate or joined in one another. They are attractive flies, attract the flies and insect. Next is the stems. What is many stems? These are placed inside the petals, and they are male reproductive part organs of the flowers. They consist of two parts, a long, thin tube-like structure called the filament. This is known as the filament, and this is the sac-like structure attached it to at the top of the is known as the anther. And anther has the numbers of the pollen grains, which is helped to germinate the which is also help to germinate the flower buds and so seeds and fruits. Now next is that the anther produces a yellow powdery substance is called a pollen grains. Pistil. It is the innermost of the part of the flowers. It is the female reproductive part of the organs, and it is consists of top of the portion called the stigma. This is known as the stigma. And next is the flower followed by the stipe styles. The styles end in the thickened ovary. The ovary contains small bead on like the structure is called the ovule. This is known as the ovule. This is the this is forming egg like structure. And this is also known as the egg. So next is that pollination. What do you mean by pollination? The flower develops into the fruit. So only when the pollen grains from the anther to anther get transferred to the stigma of the pistil. This process is called the pollination. When the pollen grains transferred from the anther to the stigma is known as the pollen grains. So, in other words, the transfer of the pollen grains from the anther to the stigma is called pollination. It is carried out by the insect, birds, winds, water is known as. This is also the media and factor which is helped to complete the pollination process. Now, next is that. Types of the pollination. Pollination are two types: self-pollination, cross-pollination. When pollen grains reach to the stigma of the same plant is known as the same plants of the flower, or anther of the flower to the of the same plants is known as the self-pollination. When the pollen grains reach the stigma of a pollen grains of a flower on the another plant, it is known as the cross-pollination. After the pollination, ovary grow up into the fruits, and the ovules from convert into the seeds. When the mature fruits fall to the ground, the seed germinate into the sapling, which is grow into the plants. So this is the process to germinating the plants and forming the seeds and fruits during the pollination process. Now next is that. Do the exercise of this chapter and send it to me at my number. If you have any doubt on this topic in this video, then you consult with me at my number. Bye, students.